And there are various type of C instruction, type declaration instruction, arithmetic instruction, control instruction. What is the purpose of these instruction? Type declarations, it declares the type of variable which are used in C program. The arithmetic instruction, in order to perform arithmetic operation between the constant variables we are going to use. The control instruction is to find out the or to implement the sequence of execution of various statement in C program. Since the elementary C program we have seen only contains the type declaration and arithmetic instruction, we'll discuss few of them just now. So type declaration instruction, the instruction is used to declare the type of variables. So this is the instruction which we use to declare our variables. So this BAS, RS, these are all variables which are declared with int, float and char. That is the memory size it will be taking. And you have to do it in the beginning of the main function in C. There can be certain variation, like that means while declaring the type of variable, we can also initialize it as like this. You can do it as I equal to 10, j equal to 25, the number of values you can give, you know, we can declare or initialize the values. You can also have, see this float a equal to 1.5, you can also have the expression here, but the order is very important. See, the order is very important because if you give I equal to 10, j equal to 25, there will be no problem. If you take j equal to 25 here and I equal to 10, there will be no problem. So you can just change it also, the order can be changed. But how about this, if you give a equal to 1.5 and b equal to a plus 3.1, but here the problem is, if you just change it, a will come here, but you are trying to find out first this, there is no a here, means compiler will not know what a value is, so there will be error in this. So first a has to be defined, then you can do anything with a. And this statement would work ABCD, ABC can be given or initialized initially as 10. But if you want to do it in the same line, int A equal to B equal to C equal to D equal to 10, this is not going to work. So you have to separate it. Now we have arithmetic instruction. The C arithmetic instruction, it can contain variable name on the left hand side, that is on the left hand side of is equal to, and then you can have variables and constant appearing on the right hand side, and with plus, minus, into, and this division, there are various operators you can use. So this is kind of example. You can have, see, AD, you have declared in the float all these values, basically variables, and now you can assign. Now you can assign, this is left hand side, and you can assign the expression also. Whole expression can be assigned to this value. So we have these as operator here. This is the is equal to is single is equal to, because double is equal to we'll be discussing. This is equation of, we equate or check for if those values are equal or not. These are the integer constants and these are the real constants. This is the integer variable here and all these are the real variables. So the variables and constants, they are good. These are called operands and they are operated upon by the arithmetic operators. And in the one more thing I would like to add here is, when we have a C arithmetic statement, this can be of three types. You can have integer, all these are integer. You can have float, see all are float, and we can have mixed. See, this is float and these are integers. So you can have a combination of these also. See, we are adding ABC, this is the integer with the num, ABC num with the values which are from here. So you can have this also and you can this also. So there can be a mix of real and integer. So these are all things which we need to understand. You cannot have two values on the left hand side. That means if you have an assignment operator, you can have z equal to say a into b into c, but you cannot have a into b equal to z. You cannot have k into l equal to z. This is illegal in C. When you are doing addition, there are two operators you have to understand, that is division and modulo. Division and modulo means, if I take 10 and 2, see, 2 and 10. If I divide 10 by 2, 2 5s are 10, you get remainder as 0. So the division operator will give you this 5, the modulo operator will give you remainder, this is 0. So whenever you take modulo, you will get 0. Whenever you take modulo, you will get the remainder. that is minus 5 divided modulo 2, let us take this, 2 minus 5. So 2 2's are 4, this gives you minus 1. So 2 is minus 5 divided by 2, and this minus 1 is minus 5 modulo 2. Modulo 2 modulo will give you the remainder, and divide will give you what? The actual this value. The arithmetic instruction is often used for storing character constant also, because initially and in the internal way, these are the characters and these are characters having some value, and these values are numbers, and these numbers are called as ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Whatever you see in the keyboard, whenever you press it, there will be a number generated. That number is actually the number which will be taken by the system, and it will understand, okay, you are discussing about F, G or plus. For example, the F has a value as 70 and G has a value 71, and you can do operation. So internally, these characters are only numbers. They are characters, and internally characters are treated as integers in your program. I hope you got the idea. Character and integers, they are no different. See, I'll give you an example. We have char xy in z. If you give x equal to a, y equal to b, a is having a value of 97 in ASCII terms. B is having the value as 98 in the this term, ASCII terms. When you say x plus y, you are adding 97 and 98 and you are assigning to z. So essentially, this is equivalent to adding two numbers. And you have to give the operators. You can't just believe that C or C++ would understand it. You have to explicitly write not dot but into. You have to write explicitly all the operators you want to. You want this expression to be worked upon. And we don't have exponentiation here like 3 double star 2 or 3 this cap 2, but we have a power function. This power function comes from the include library, that is math.h in C. This power function, say if you want to find out 3 square, just use power 3 2 and include this math.h. This is the file which is already library file present in your C compiler. So this power function can be used for the exponentiation.